This English electric Canberra first went into service in 1955 with the Royal Air Force. It was an aeroplane that was sort of on the drawing board late World War II to replace the Mosquito. This specific Canberra finished service in the RAF as a TT-18, a target tug, and was acquired by the museum nearly 20 years ago, where it was operated here at Tamora for about 10 years, and it hasn't flown now for another 10 years. From the servicing point of view and maintenance, the Canberra is a beautiful aeroplane to look after. It's very robust in design. I think the designers were venturing into a bit of an unknown territory with, you know, gas turbine engines, high altitudes. So if in doubt, they made it bigger, stronger, better. And it certainly makes maintaining them today a lot easier. During the major inspection that we've carried out over the last 3 years, we've decided to fit an electric starter to the aeroplane. The main problem with the cartridge start, although it's, you know, really cool and iconic Canberra, is it's very corrosive to the engine. So each time it starts, the nitroglycerin base explosive that comes out the exhaust gets drawn into the engine and does cause a lot of corrosion to the aluminium compressor blades. The starter system that we've installed on the Canberra is mainly derived from the de Havilland Comet, the 520 series Avons. We're able to track down most of the parts to fit it to the engines. A lot of the control, batteries, relays, that sort of thing is new generation parts. The operation of vintage aeroplanes isn't an easy undertaking. It is very complex. It requires a lot of research and homework. In the case of a Canberra, it was in service for, well, up until I think 2006 with the RAF. They learnt a lot about how Canberras age in their long utilisation of the type. As a result of that, non-destructive testing is one of the main tools used to see deterioration in the airframe, and X-rays are used a lot through the wing structure. Also, nowadays, operating a historic type, we don't fly them as hard as they were during service, so our operational weights are a lot lower, our G load that we expose the airplane to is a lot lower, and just general flying, you know, we don't fly it in turbulent air, we don't fly it near thunderstorms, that sort of thing, where, you know, in service these airplanes have to take that sort of punishment. For anyone who's operating an older type of airplane, it's very important they take on board the age of the aeroplane. Also, the type clubs that exist around the world are a fabulous source of information. Thankfully, you know, in the case of this aeroplane, we've got a library of manuals and inspection manuals and servicing procedures that cover all this. But for a lot of your GA fleet, that information isn't around, and the only way you can really tap into that is through the type clubs that exist.